Imagine you're always running the same sequence of commands, whether that's cleaning up logs, pulling updates, customizing your workflows, whatever it is. Why not simplify things with a script? Because bash scripting allows you to combine commands into one file, turning them into reusable tools, which is fantastic. You can share these with others. Now, of course, you could use aliases, which are a nice way to put some simple commands behind your own command alias. But when things get more complicated, bash scripting is the way to go. So I'm going to show you how to do that today. Now, consider an example like this. I'm at the terminal, I've got this sequence of commands to update my system. I could create my own command. Maybe it would be update all, and update all would simply do all of these commands for me. It makes sense. It sounds like it's going to do an update of everything. How do I do that? I've got to create a bash script. Now, bash scripts are simply just files that contain commands like these, and we use bash scripting to be able to simplify our workflow and our processes by hiding complicated things behind simple files that do all of it for us. Now, of course, we've got to write these files, and if you're new to bash scripting, some of this might be a bit confusing, but if you bear with me, I think you'll find it quite straightforward. So my advice would be to create your own scripts directory, and then within that, you can store things like this. So I've created a scripts directory here at the home, and I'm going to create my own script. So I'm going to come back over to the terminal here. Let's get rid of that. And I'm going to use a script called update all. And I'm going to use Nano, the text editor, to go in there and start editing it. Now, I'm going to show you a pre-prepared script, which is going to run this update command along with some echo statements to let the user know what's going on. If we go into update all, here's what we have. So at the top, I've got my shebang followed by bin bash that informs that we're going to be using bash to execute this script. Notice I've got an echo statement saying updating your system, so that lets the user know what's happening. And then there is that sequence of commands. We were just looking at all the update commands together. Finally, we've got system update complete to let the user know when it's all done. And this is a very simple bash script, and I think you can follow along with this very easily. And the idea here is that this script file is going to be hidden behind a command, and that command is update all. And when I run update all, I am then going to be able to run this without having to ever write anything out again other than update all, which is really simple. If I'm doing this on the regular, why would I not make my life simpler? That's what bash scripting does. It makes your life so much simpler. Any complicated sequence of commands, put it in a script, never write it out again. And it's also a nice persisted record of the commands. So you ever need to refresh your memory, there it is. You haven't to go bashing through command history and figure out what you were doing. It's in the script file. Now, something I have to point out is that once you've created your script and you've written this out, obviously you need to exit, but I need to make sure that it is executable, because of course, being a script, it's not going to be executed if it isn't executable. So we'd use chmod, add x, and then we would simply add that to update all, and then our update all file would be executable, and then we'd be able to run it by simply typing out update all. Or would we? Well, that's a question, because what's important to note is that we want to be able to add this so that we can run this script from anywhere. And the important thing to do is that we need to add a line to our bash RC file. And this line, and obviously our bash RC file is our configuration file for the bash shell, we're going to add this line and we're going to basically add to the path. So the path is going to know to look inside the scripts directory. And when it looks in there, it's going to be able to execute these commands for us from absolutely anywhere in the directory system. So if I were to open up the bash RC file, and if I scroll all the way to the bottom here, you're going to see that we have an export statement, which we're going to use. And this export statement is exporting here. So I've got export path equals home /scripts to path. So what we're doing here is we're saying add this directory to our path. Look inside this directory for things to execute. Then it's going to know that that is there. Now, what I want to say is that if you're using Z shell, obviously you might have to use a different configuration file, but the general principle still applies. So this is all looking pretty good, but I actually think we could do better than this. I think we could add some interactivity to our script. Rather than just blindly executing all of these updates, maybe we should interact with the user to ask them whether they're happy to do so beforehand. And this is how we can add some more complication and complexity to our script, but it also makes our script a lot more user-friendly. So let's get to that in a moment. So let's now open up our text editor and have a look at an updated version of update all. So here you can see what we've got. Now at the top, we've got this shebang with bin bash again, because this is still a bash script. Notice we've got a lot more going on here, and it's still fairly simple. And even if you're brand new to bash scripting, I'm sure you can follow along with the logic of what's going on here. So we're reading in, we're giving the choice to the user. Are you sure you want to update your system? Yes or no? And we're using the Y or N to prompt them to say we want a Y or N, as if we didn't, they might type in anything. And then we're assigning that to the choice variable. Then we've got a simple conditional setup. We've got if the choice is equal to a lowercase or an uppercase y, then do something. Else echo that update was cancelled. So notice it's just an if else. And with bash scripting, when you've got an if, you close it with a fee. it's like a mirroring. I think it's quite cute personally, but if you're not used to this, it might seem confusing, but that's just how it works in bash scripting. So essentially, if the choice is equal to a lowercase or an uppercase y, then we enter into that conditional branch and we want to echo out updating the system. We'll then do the updates and echo out system update complete. Yep, everything from our first script file is now within that if clause. That's all we've done. We've moved it into a conditional. So we're giving the user the choice to say whether they want to continue or not. If they say yes, we're going to run that. If they say no, we're not. And then that will be everything done. So same thing applies. You've got this, you write it out, you save it, you ensure you've got the executable permissions for that file. And now because our path is already pointed to this directory, what I should be able to do is run this and then it will ask me whether I want to confirm or not. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to give this a test right now. Let's try update all. And there we go. I am now being asked if I want to update my system. I'm going to say no. But that is how we now have one command that wraps that all up. And just to prove it runs from anywhere, I'm going to go up and I'm going to run it again. And that's not going to work, of course. Update all. And there we go. Yes or no. So it is now running from absolutely anywhere within our... So I need to say no to this. Let's clear the screen. I'm going to change to my Linux demo. And I'm going to try it here as well, just to prove that. And as you can see, this command is running from everywhere. We've now created a command which is behind, or rather has behind it, a bash script, which is doing all the logic for us. And we haven't got to remember to do it ever again at the terminal because we've done it within a bash script. So the thing about the terminal is a fantastic place, but we need to combine it with our bash scripting skills where possible to try and make it even more efficient. This is how power users work. This is how system admins work. And as you can see, this was a very easy way to take something repetitive and simple, but make it even simpler and even more intuitive and user-friendly. And as I mentioned, this is portable. You could take this script file with you anywhere. You can share it with your friends, share it with your colleagues, and everyone will have this. So there you have it. That is a quick intro into creating your own Linux commands with bash scripting. Rather than relying on aliases for simple commands, we can get way more complex and build out these very complicated bash scripts and hide them behind very simple commands. And then whether you're streamlining your workflows or you're just geeking out and you want to learn more about Linux, you'll find that bash scripts are super powerful tools to have in your arsenal. So I think you will hopefully find that this idea can take your Linux use to another level that you hadn't even considered. So what's your first command going to be? What are you going to create? Is there something that you're doing all the time? You think, God, I don't want to type this out every single time. Maybe you could create a bash script. Maybe that is the way to go with this. So I'd love to hear what you think about this. Hope you've enjoyed this video and I can't wait to see you in the next one.